What's going on, guys? Welcome back to RuneScape. In today's video, I'm going to be talking you through my Duo Virago progress. This footage and commentary pretty much is taken from around 4 to 6 weeks ago. So it's a very long time ago now when I was doing Duo Virago attempts, but there was a stage in the game and a stage on this channel where I did not upload any content for 2 weeks straight. And the reason behind that is because every second of spare time that I had was invested into doing Duo Virago. I am still doing a lot of Telos progress right now in the game, but I just want to change a pace on the channel for you guys. And I thought, you know, this is a good time to look back in time when I was doing Duo Virago. I've had this video on hold for ages. I think it's a good time to release it for you guys to watch through. And it's something which I will go ahead and attempt again in the future, but I'm not sure when. But most likely it'll either be the Purple Bomb or Scopulous rotation when they come across. And even the Team Split rotation is a doable Duo Virago rotation. But yeah, moving on to the rest of today's video. Oh, by the way, streams will be reduced at the moment because I've got a lot going on at work. Videos may also be impacted, but I'm going to try and keep my video content going throughout the next week or the next 2 weeks, but I'm going to be very, very busy across those 2 weeks. Also, anyone who's interested, I have booked RuneFest tickets and I will be going to RuneFest 2016. But moving on to the rest of today's video, lots and lots to cover. I'm going to try my best to fit it all in to a decent length video. So I'm just going to take a couple of random examples from the hours and hours of footage that I did gather on my external hard drive. And a lot of these examples are where mistakes were made and what I've learned from those mistakes. And I'd say now I'm at the stage where I can get a kill. It's just nerves that get the best of me sometimes when you're going for your first ever kill at something. And once you get that first kill ticked off the list, you can then start progressively getting more. But like with most things, when you get your first kill out of the way, you know, it does give you a huge confidence boost and you stop making those silly little mistakes. And a lot of those mistakes I'm going to be showing you in today's video is like a progress vid and to show you what I went through and what I learned from just doing the boss and just, you know, having a laugh with it to an extent. But yeah, it was it was fun when I look back at it and coming home from work and, you know, just grinding out the hours for it. And it was fun doing it and I will get back into it at some point in the near future. But yeah, Duo Virago is super difficult. It's probably the hardest thing I've attempted on this game up until Telos. And the only thing I've not used yet to assist me in Duo Virago is Planted Feet, and that extends the duration of your sunshine. And you attach this to a sunspear, and you can switch the combat style of the weapon. And it's a future video that I'll upload probably. But it does give you an advantage. I've got the rep to get it now. I just don't have the money to buy it because I'm banked for it from Telos multiple times. But anyway, my duo partner has been taking the Guthic staff as well. I actually do have that now, and it's something which I can use because I use it at Telos. Despite the patch that happened there, where Telos can now regenerate its stats, it still works effectively, you just can't stack it. But this is also something I want to use and learn the best times of when to use it at Duo Virago. And this works like the Statius Warhammer, where it reduces the target's defense level by 4 and allows you to have higher accuracy against Virago for a duration of time. You need to complete the Mage Arena minigame in order to unlock the staff, and then to unlock the actual spell, you must cast the spell Divine Storm, I think it's called, 100 times on the mages inside the arena. So these clips are in no particular order, so the gear will change fairly often when I'm getting used to different things, maybe different auras and things like that. Maniacal works fine, and Supreme Runic Accuracy I found are pretty much similar in the way that they work in terms of the pushback on Phase 5. Because the defense is balanced out by the accuracy and damage output that Maniacal offers, and it just varies that way. Runic Accuracy is just pure accuracy. But the gear, I was using Augmented Tier 90 gear, Seismics at first. I eventually bought myself a Noxious Staff, perked it up as well with Aftershock, and it's really nice to use this staff in Duo Virago in any DPS situation because of Sonic Wave, where it gives you that accuracy boost. It's nice to use Sonic Wave before D-bills in Phase 5 as well to make sure that you have a higher chance of that D-bill activating, because that can really impact you in the pushback. I also have Merciless with Turtling, but I also have an Arcane Switch too for when I'm purely tanking without Cade. Another little tip I can give you guys, if you spam a basic ability at the start of the next phase, so it states Message cannot find a target, and then Threshold of Defensive, example Revenge straight after it, then it won't actually reduce your Adren, and you can still retain your Adren that way as well, and it's all about retaining your Adren throughout these fights, as any high level PVM would know these days when you're going between phases. The Saruman book is the best god book still, I think, to use in phase 5, but it was super expensive when I was using it. It was around 3 to 4 mil a page. I've heard they've gone down now due to a clue update where you can get multiple pages within a clue. So I think the pages are now around 2 mil each, which is way better. Guthix pages for Telos are now only 1 mil each. So that's fantastic, although I do use elements there fairly often. But yeah, each page lasts 45 minutes worth of charge. You can switch out the Sara book for a Zamorak book as well and save costs a little, and that still works okay, just slightly less damage. Super Saruman brews, I think I was using it mostly throughout these clips. Potentially they were worth 100k each, and that was probably the most expensive item I was using at that moment, other than god books, and the deaths do add up as well. Overall, I invested about 18 mil into Virago attempts across the 2 week period, I think. But yeah, let's have a look at some epic deaths. I KO'd myself completely. I got Shrek'd by bombs to start off with, but on top of that, I also wow magicked myself. Me and Chewie were laughing our asses off with this one. We watched this back multiple times because every single time you watched it, you just saw something different. I didn't even notice I wow magicked myself until 3 times watching it. Because there was just so many bombs that Shrek'd me anyway, it was ridiculous. And this was an old method that I was using for purple bomb rotation in phase 3, where I was just tanking all of the bombs in one go. And later on, you'll see us use an intercept method, which I think I'll show straight after this. But yeah, always get off right before the first red hits you on purple bomb rotation phase, otherwise this happens. But yeah, this was the old way I did it, tanking a shitload of bombs, and the damage was just unreal. But after a few hours, I decided to move on to the intercept method, which just works an absolute dream. Yeah, it's fantastic. So just before we head into those phases, in phase 2, I usually lure it to the base spot wherever possible to save having to run around a lot. But sometimes there is a chance Virago will just push you back out of the base spot when voking back, but it's fantastic. That base spot in phase 2 works an absolute dream and just makes that phase a lot easier for everybody involved. But let's move on to the new method here for phase 3 and 4. So wherever there is a blue bomb spawn in the corner, I would intercept my teammate. I'd have devotion on the ready, make sure I pray mage, and then I tank all of those blues that come out before Virago stands up. And it's all about one person taking it off the other and tanking those. And you can also, if you don't want to intercept the reds, you can just tag the reds each. One person takes 2, the other one takes 1. However, what I do again, I'll get the other person just to take all reds, and I will intercept those as well. So then, and I will cage those reds completely before we even reach the end of that rotation. And that way, when I'm bomb tanking on the outside, I'm not going to be taking as much damage anymore. I'm not taking multiple reds. I'm not taking all the blues. All I have to do is just tank a purple and then tank a red later on. And that makes it so much smoother, and you're not having to risk as much because you're not taking as much damage anymore. Anyways, with this method, I found I was using way less food and going into phase 5 with like half a yak still left or something. And all of that was just going away because I'd switched to my Nihil. And I know some people, the real pros, will take yak scrolls just so they can rebank all their brews and stuff so they don't lose as much money. So yeah, I am looking back at this 4 or 6 weeks ago, so I don't know it as in depth right now as when I was doing it back then. But if you move on to managing your DPS correctly, and this is something that I really had to get my head around, and still do have to get my head around now because I still haven't got a kill. But the most important thing, one of the most important things, is always following a Sun Adren rotation, depending on what rotation it is. But if you're using Sunshine in that rotation, it's all about following that Sun Adren. And at times, I was forced to use an Adren pot to reach a Cade, and those times should not happen often. And you don't want them to happen at all if possible, because you want to be saving your Adren for when you're DPSing, not just to reach Cade to tank the blues and the purple, for example. And, you know, when we've still got a lot of push to deal with, I should really be managing my Adren better to reach Cade. And the main cause of my lack of Adren build for the first maybe few hours of doing it, maybe 5-6 hours, was I wasn't coordinating the bleeds with my teammate. And when I went with a teammate where we were coordinating bleeds, it was very effective because instead at times I was using thresholds in the past where I should have been using basic bleeds to build up my Adren. And if possible, it's always nice to be able to sneak out while magics and a couple of bleeds before you cade whilst bomb tanking. And that is a technique called sneaking. And it's very, very nice to do in Geo Virago, where every little ability, and every little hit really, really counts for the pushback and for the stall. It's really nice to sneak out a wild magic in order to stall it, to allow you to deal more DPS before you reach your Cade, and because you've stalled him, because you've pushed him back, you will stall the blue bombs from actually being released from Virago, and therefore you can Cade a little bit later. And you know, on the early days, I was using Reflect on phase 5, and that is just a complete adrenaline waste, and I was using it to reduce my damage intake, but it doesn't impact the pushback whatsoever, and you should be fine on food. As you can see, I hadn't came across this mistake yet, and as I click on Virago here, I ran in whilst equipping my rapier, and you'll see how this is detrimental in the next clip. So because I'm used to using magic, I'll click on Virago and it stops you from going any further when you start attacking. With melee, you of course need to be MD to hit Virago, and that was just habit that I had to get rid of. I instantly got rid of it after making this mistake, and again, something like this for me just requires consistency and picking up habits. Another thing to note when making a mistake, which is something I had to really get over mentally, is that, and this is easier said than done, is just to try and keep yourself together and try your best to keep going. Early days in, when I made a mistake, they would just then roll on from there and I wouldn't be able to recover. But the best people out there, when they make a mistake, they will be able to recover it and then make a huge recovery to get the kill down and to push Virago back. And that's where the true pros really separate themselves from the people who are just getting the odd kill or not even got a kill yet. And later down the line, I hope to start recovering much better if I do get back into this. So moving on to some good clips, at least where I feel I was doing okay in terms of removing the bleeds. Essentially, the things to note when taking bleeds are, if it's the purple bomb rotation, run in on the third blue and stay to the side. This way you won't hit your partner who's also running in on their side. But make sure you hit freedom on the first bleed, tank that blue, and then move into the center. And you want to be moving in, because if you get the second bleed as you're running in, you will not be able to clear it. So you want to escape out on the second, switch to your melee weapon, which I have keybinded, which is my rapier, I think, at the moment. Wait, do not move anywhere. Hit barge, which is also keybinded, on the third. That will also clear the bleed, and therefore you've cleared all three bleeds. And then with time, I started to get better at DPSing within the bleeds. And this is where you coordinate bleeds and thresholds with your partner. And that's like Corruption Blast and Combust. I still need to improve on sneaking more abilities out amongst the bleeds. The team split rotation, it's more important to get the bleeds on point every time, but you should be aiming to remove all bleeds instantly on any rotation. But this is something which you can make a mistake on fairly easily with a lack of concentration, and then it's about being able to recover. On team split, you get bleeds instantly after reflex, so use an auto attack, see if the first bleed hits you. If it doesn't, whip out an ability and then prep for your second bleed. This is just something that comes with practice, something that I picked up from hours of doing it, and nerves can get the better of you here. I've just got to keep remaining calm at this point of the kill. Deeps, but don't be too risky with it, and instead calculate your DPS amongst the bleeds. Debilitate I found was super important and can really make a difference as well. If you're debilling whilst wearing a shield as well and then switch to your staff, it will cancel your debill, so that's something to note. Debuffs also very, very important. You want to coordinate those with your partner, especially when one of you's got to take a Guthic staff, for example, and debuff that way, which also helps a huge deal. But you do want to be taking vulnerability and enfeeble. So yeah, the closest I've got to achieving a kill is 3 squares off. And for me, it's just consistency. I've got the mechanics, or I did get the mechanics laid down. Like I said, probably forgot pretty much everything now, and it would take me at least a couple of hours to get back into it, at least. But I just need more consistency. I had to stop doing it because Telos was released, and instead I switched my focus, and it was a good break for me, to be honest, and it will be fun to delve back into it. But yeah, for me personally, I've just got to stop making those silly mistakes. I can't describe how painful it is when I fail a kill that has momentum. Pretty much every attempt now is good enough to get the kill if I don't make a bleed mistake, for example. And it's kind of scary how obsessed I am about getting this kill, or it was scary how obsessed I was. And that's how obsessed I am right now with Telos. And that's kind of how I get in games like this, in MMOs, where you really want to succeed in a certain point. You want to reach a goal. Sometimes it's nice to take a break away from it, because the annoyance to succeed can really get hold of you. And like I said, this is so difficult. It was the most difficult thing up until Telos, and maybe Telos is now, because I've had to read and count loads of different attacks. Maybe I'm at a different standard now than what I was when I was doing Geo Virago, despite it being a group effort and Telos being a solo effort. But I don't know. I don't know where I'm at. But I'm close to getting the Warden title. I cannot wait to share that with you, and I'm still pushing for that right now. One thing I do like about Telos is that it's all about a personal goal. You can go at your own speed. You put your hours in where you want to put your hours in. You can use your auras when you want to use your auras. And it's all about your own self-motivation. And you can do it whenever you want because it's solo. That is a perk of that boss. But I did really enjoy doing Duo Virago, having a laugh with mates whilst doing it and interacting a lot more and being sociable. And that is a big part of the game for me. You know, I feel like it was worth the effort that I put in, despite not getting a kill yet. But thank you to all of those who have helped me get into the Duo Virago kills, as we were having to get four people or two other people to tank the damage into the entrance of Virago. And also thanks to Chewy, Julius and Buffy for the duo attempt so far. Chewy put a heck of a lot of hours in with me, and I know we'll get a kill one day, mate. We'll get a kill one day. Good luck all of those with Telos at the moment who are doing it. I mean, in my commentary it said good luck all Telos tomorrow. This video was supposed to be out weeks ago, so hopefully you guys have enjoyed this interim, a bit of a break from all the Telos content. And yeah, I'm gonna get back to grinding Telos on the one title. I'm also playing a lot of, but I'm playing a bit of Battlefield at the moment because I know Battlefield 1's coming out in October. I think it's October 21st. That looks incredible. And I'm also playing Overwatch from time to time. But thank you guys for listening and watching this extremely long video. I guess it's a Sunday, just chilling out before the week ahead. I appreciate all of the support on the channel. I want to say a big thank you as well. We just reached 25,000 subs. We did reach that earlier, but then YouTube went through a big thing of just removing loads of inactive subscribers, but we've re-reached it again, 25,000. Thank you so much, guys. I really appreciate every single one of you who are just watching any video that I upload onto this channel. It really means a lot to me. Thank you so much for the continuous support, and I'll see you all in the next one.